Websites are now more compelling and interactive due to the emphasis placed on user experience, but that also makes them more complex, and that's a challenge for many scraping enthusiasts. To do the job, they must turn to modern web automation frameworks like Selenium and Playwright. The tricky part is choosing the right one for the project. I'm Liza, and today let's compare Selenium and Playwright and how to choose between the two. Selenium is an open-source framework dedicated to cross-browser testing and automation. From its humble beginnings as an internal testing tool, Selenium has evolved into a project that many companies as well as solo programmers use. Let's take a look at the key components of Selenium. Selenium WebDriver, a tool that provides a programming interface to create and execute browser-based text scripts across different browsers and platforms. Selenium IDE, a record and playback test automation solution. Selenium Grid, a tool used to execute WebDriver scripts on remote machines. Microsoft made Playwright available to the public only a few years ago, but it has already become a widely used tool. Similarly to Selenium, it's a cross-browser web automation library. Interestingly, Playwright was built by the same team that developed Puppeteer, which means they share similar features such as API methods. But Playwright is designed to simplify end-to-end testing for developers and testers who intend to utilize it across various browsers. As a result, it supports browser engines such as Chromium, Firefox, and WebKit. Finally, it's an open-source tool that only requires Node.js to get started. If Selenium and Playwright are test automation tools, how are they relevant to web scraping? The answer lies in their ability to control headless browsers. But to understand web scraping with a headless browser, we need to get into the differences between static and dynamic pages. A static website consists of multiple web pages developed with the help of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Everything you see on that page is exactly what other users see. Most importantly, static web pages are stored in HTML files, meaning web scrapers can easily acquire them through an HTTP request. Dynamic web pages, however, are developed with server-side language and can render content based on user behavior. So two users might see completely different content based on their location, browsing history, or device specifications. The majority of the time, JavaScript is used to display dynamic pages, which poses numerous challenges for web scrapers like asynchronous loading, infinite scrolling, and more. So what's the role of headless browsers in this? Headless browsing allows interaction with a browser without a GUI. You command the browser to simulate actions like clicking, downloading, or scrolling by writing a script. Without having to load visual elements, you'll need fewer resources and will be able to upscale operations. For example, you can spawn numerous browser instances, allowing you to scrape different websites simultaneously. Additionally, websites are able to know if an internet user can execute JavaScript to render a website. Clients who can't do that might be flagged as a bot and get blocked. By using a headless browser while scraping, you can overcome this issue. If both Selenium and Playwright can help you with headless browsing, how can you know which one to choose? Let's take a look at key points you should consider before opting for one or the other. Selenium supports a huge variety of browser options. However, the user still needs to install specific web drivers for each browser. Playwright supports Chromium, Firefox, WebKit, but it comes with an inbuilt driver, which makes implementing it much easier. It's important to know that Selenium has recently launched Selenium Manager to circumvent the web driver management problem. However, it's currently under beta testing, and using it can still cause issues with your workflow. Being an older tool, Selenium supports far more programming languages than Playwright, with its main ones being Java, Python, Ruby, C#, and JavaScript. Furthermore, with Selenium's client language bindings, you can also use Go, Haskell, PHP, Perl, R, and Dart. Playwright supports TypeScript, JavaScript, Python, .NET, and Java. While it's less than Selenium provides, Playwright is easier to implement, so if your language is supported, Playwright might be the better choice. In terms of speed, Selenium is regarded as being slower than Playwright. The former is more suitable for small to average size scraping projects, as more computing power will significantly reduce speed. To make an informed decision, check out some tests and comparisons of the two that we included in the video description. As Playwright is more recent than Selenium, it lacks the internet resources Selenium provides. Selenium features a sizable and active community with a ton of in-depth documentation. As a result, when you hit a roadblock, you'll probably be able to find assistance online. Selenium and Playwright are based on different architectures. As mentioned before, for Selenium, you can install a language-specific client driver to write scripts capable of interacting with the web driver. Moreover, this will be done using HTTP by extension JSON payload. In a nutshell, every line of Selenium code will require JSON wire protocol to be sent, which might produce delays. Playwright, on the other hand, uses an event-driven architecture based on decoupled systems that respond to events, otherwise known as user or system-generated actions. This means that each component is independent and interacts with other components by interchanging events. It allows for asynchronous communication, which makes the system more scalable, flexible, and faster. Overall, both Selenium and Playwright are excellent test automation that can be used for web scraping. However, Playwright is best for when your project's needs can be met by Playwright-supported languages and browsers. Choose Playwright for a fast, efficient, and simple-to-implement headless browser. Selenium is best when flexibility is required and you wish to employ a very specific browser and programming language combination. Additionally, given the range of resources accessible online, Selenium may be a useful tool for learning web scraping with a headless browser. Liked this video? Be sure to hit like and subscribe for more content like this.